World Machine is an event that's happening on and in front of Durham Cathedral, which is a 10-minute show of images projected onto the cathedral, which tell the story of the birth of modern cosmology, to a soundtrack of music written by me. Helen Marriage, who's the director of Artichoke, which are the events company that run this, I met her in August, I think, and then I had a few projects happening at the time, so I started really writing in September, and then was just writing solidly for about 6 weeks. For this project, it was a sort of combination of the sort of academic scientific side of things, at the story of the birth of modern cosmology, and also the phenomenal images and the artwork, the projection mapping onto the cathedral. That created the good sort of narrative arc, which starts from the sort of Big Bang and goes through and amazing images of all the elements. You know, there's the cathedral is sort of lit on fire and it melts and it all of those sorts of things, and then we get galaxies and we see the solar system. So that was a heavy influence on the shape of the music. And then in terms of the actual material, we had a lot of conversations about the sort of style of it, what it should sound like, what the emotional sort of intentions should be, what the kind of forces should be. So we decided eventually on an orchestra and a choir, and then sort of slightly zanier electronic things for the more sort of space age moments. For me, the two people that are crucial in terms of my involvement, but also in terms of bringing the whole event to life, are the sound designers John Del Nero and Sebastian Frost. They have designed this kind of epic sound system which completely covers the area in and around the cathedral, the sort of vast area which holds thousands of people when they're all standing looking at the cathedral. I collaborated with them from the very beginning. We spoke about all sorts of different musical styles and bounced ideas around, and then I would go away and write the music, and then I would send it to them and they would come back to me with some feedback, and then they would add additional elements, additional effects to the music, which would further tie the music to the images. For me, collaboration is one of the best parts of what I do. So being given the opportunity to collaborate with such creative geniuses as these two was incredibly exciting. Because until somebody says, you have to hand it in now, it's all over, you'll always find things that you want to keep tweaking. So even since we've been here, you know, there have been sort of things you think, oh, actually it could do with a bit more, you know, one more bell or something like that. It's endless sort of improvements, really. It's the briefing, really, I think. It's really about how to serve whatever it's being used for the best. So if it's underscoring some dialogue and it's being used to kind of enhance a moment, the only thing that I'll be thinking about while I'm writing is it working for that moment? I never think about the listeners when I'm doing work like that. That when the music is collaborating with other things, I'm not thinking about the listener, I'm thinking about the other things when I'm writing. But if the music is a standalone piece,
that's slightly different. If it's sort of just for the concert hall, or I might end up thinking about the listener, but I think that's a mistake to do that. I think it's, if you're true to yourself, then it will become a unique thing. Quite detailed, emotional, I think. Can you say that? I don't know. Can I say that about my own music? I don't know. I think people might say that. Melodic, I think. And hopefully quite fun at times, you know, not always doom and gloom and drama, but sort of a little bit more, sometimes a little bit twinkly. I think it is quite subtle, although ironically this, The World Machine, is probably the least subtle thing I've ever done. It is, which was actually, that was what made it so fun, because usually it's funny, with music, when you're scoring things, there's a kind of, you don't want to be too manipulative. And so there's got to be, in the same way that there's a subtext in the dialogue, there should sort of be a subtext in the music. But with this, there's like no subtext required at all. So I was specifically asked to be really epic, absolutely huge. And to make people cry, so.
And it's worked. Because it brought a tear to my eye.
Has it? Oh, that's good. I am definitely influenced by other composers. They've taught me a lot in terms of technically. They've taught me a lot, particularly when you're writing for an orchestra. So the big composers, like Stravinsky and. The sort of Mahlers and late Romantic composers, they, you know, big sweeping melodies and that sort of thing, and how to make those kind of big and effective. Those composers certainly tapped into something in me. I think I'm not one of those composers who I only want to write film music, or I only want to write ballets. I just want to write music. I think that's the thing, is that I love writing music. So I suppose the big goal would be to be making the choices to write the things that I really feel passionately about. So that could be anything. I mean, I definitely, on my list I have, you know, an opera. I really want to write a big opera. And, you know, I suppose scale is kind of, I really want the scale of things. I'm excited about doing bigger things. Like this sort of thing is absolutely insane and extraordinary. Any minute. Any minute now.
So you're waiting for the crowd, are you?
No, I think it's a weird one, that, because I know I'm a composer. I know I'm employed to write music. So I understand that I'm a composer, and other people do as well. But it's that weird thing of sometimes I do wake up in the morning and I'm working and I'm writing and I think, oh, I'm a composer, that's what I do. I'm sure that would sound crazy, but I think in truth, when I was first paid money to write music for someone, I listened to quite a lot of ambient music. It's quite gentle, the things that I listen to when I'm kind of relaxing. So a lot of sort of Scandinavian composers, and a lot of instrumental music. Actually, I don't listen to that many songs, I realised. But it really depends on my mood. I know specifically what I should listen to in relation to sort of how I'm feeling. So I might really want to listen to some M. Ward or Elliot Smith.